Hello, YouTube land and fellow YouTubers. How are y'all doing today? I hope you're doing great. I love watching your videos, everybody. And just enjoying this great YouTube channel as ever. Just want to update you on kind of what's going on in the shop here. I got a little package the other day, which is helping me quite a bit on my Briggs FH project. What I'd like to do is open it up now and show you what the heck is going on here in this project. Finally, after saving up a few nickels and dimes, because I can't find them cheap anymore, but I got the carb for the FH. And I am really looking forward to getting into the final stages of putting this together and getting it running, because I want to hear it, I guess. That's one of the big things. But anyways, here she goes. I may repaint her eventually and everything, but just right now it's kind of the challenge is getting the parts. And it's wonderful having the carb finally, or the mixer. I don't know if you can really call these a carburetor on the old FH. It's basically a little gadget that mixes the the air and the gas together. It's not a great piece of workmanship or anything fabulous like a modern carburetor. But anyways, it's here, and pretty soon the old slant fin will start up and run. I am really happy I got this part. And I hope all you folks are getting your parts for your hard-to-source items or old engines or anything unique, modern, yada, 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 so that you can get your machines running and enjoy them. The tube, I had a tube for this, the feeder tube, that goes up here. And it was the wrong one. So the other day I went back out to eBay and said, oh shoot, man, I need to get this, the tube for it. And I don't know who it was that sent me this. I got to get the paperwork on. But they make this tube, and they do a better job, of course, than Briggs originally did. They put a nub on here. It looks like it's brazed on or something. I don't know if you can see that through the camera. Looks like a little brass stop or something. And they have one on the bottom too. Which this is really great, because if you ever had to mess with these things, they really don't have... They had kind of a hump or a bump that goes around it, but you need something to stop it, because when you put this tube in, if it doesn't fit right, it's going to cause you issues with the running and all that stuff. So there she goes. I got it on bass backwards. I got to turn around here. All right. Get the tube in. Anyways, I'll have to mess around with fitting it later, but that tube goes on here like this. And, she'll be feeding fuel and she'll be popping away. Once I get the, ignition together, I want to bead blast it. I still want to clean this. I really want this thing to be put together nice. I'm not trying to be some kind of neat freak, but I just want it to be nice and clean and, running well. So many of them I put together are greasy and crappy, and then I have problems later on because there's too much grease on them or whatever. But anyways, I just wanted to update you on that, and I hope everybody's having a great summer. I hope everybody is enjoying all their projects and they're making good progress. I want to thank you all, and this is kind of neat, having people from different parts of the country that we're in touch with. Like, I'm down south here, and Road King, he's up, I guess he's probably close to Jersey somewhere, New Jersey. Old Chevy 4x4, he's over in Tennessee. And MBYR31, he's up there in Wisconsin, up in the heartland or whatever, the Northland. You know, it's really cool. You know, we actually get to know and see what people are doing in different parts of this country without having to, jump on an airplane or drive up or something like that. Thank God for YouTube. This is great. Well, anyways, I guess I've talked long enough. Hope you folks enjoy the video and, keep on posting because I'm watching. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.